We associate stalags with death, forced work, illness and hunger, but the prisoners didn't forget about things they loved. Some drew portraits of their companions, others wrote poems, made sculptures, played football or other sports.
Did the prisoners have free time?
It depended on the nationality. French, Italian and German prisoners had the most free time, but only on Sundays.
How much free time did they have?
The whole Sunday, from the moment they woke up to 10 p.m.
What did they do during their free time?
They wrote letters, they had meetings, played cars, played football, they took care about cleanliness, they took part in Eucharist and they watched theater shows.
Did they do sports?
They probably did the runs, jumping, boxing, but there were no sports facilities.
There were twisted views about music in camps. In some camps, music was illegal, but they still would play little concerts in the barracks to cheer each other up. Mostly, this was tolerated by the SS. In other camps, prisoners had to play concerts for the amusement of the SS, and only sometimes the fellow prisoners were allowed to listen. They associated music with terror, as they were often forced to sing German war songs.
As we already mentioned, many prisoners sketched companions or events on scraps of paper. Some also wrote poetry or diary. They used everyday items for sculptures. For example, bed frogs became little airplanes. There were also theater performances, which were often used for propaganda films.
In some camps, prisoners were able to do sports. There were football teams and boxing competitions. The Nazis even claimed that the prisoner called organized their own Olympic Games in 1940 and 1944 to beat the prisoners hastily and entertain them.
Sometimes prisoners also got books and magazines from families and charities. Others made their own figure so that they could play chess.
However, these activities could not cover up the cruelty of the camps and only meant a few minutes to forget about their tragic destiny. Still, they gave them hope.